Hi friends, today I am going to talk about a very important document which I saw about 1.5 years back. It is the document is titled as Alien Interview. So the editor of the document is Lawrence R. Spencer. So he published this book at the end of 2008. It describes a telepathic interview between a Roswell Army nurse named as Matilda O'Donnell Musselroy. So this lady, before her death, gave this document to this man named Lawrence Spencer, and he published a book. The lady and the telepathic interview between the lady and the alien being was transcribed by a stenographer in the U.S. Army. Then the U.S. Army people, because of the strangeness of the document, because of the unbelievable nature of the document, did not take it seriously, and she managed to keep the document with herself, and she divulged this document to this man named Lawrence Spencer during 2007, and the book was published in 2008, as I already said. So, and this document is one of the most important documents in recent history, in my opinion, and this document really has changed my life to an extent which I can't describe in words. So I have attached this document as a video version verbatim in my YouTube channel. So it takes about more than 4 hours, and I attached timestamps for itself too, so the viewers can see which part of the document they want to see. So that is that can be done with the help of the timestamps which I attached. And what I'm going to do is, I'm going to release a series of videos regarding the various topics and chapters in this document, and I'm going to talk about a specific topic or a specific chapter which describes a specific aspect of this document, and I'm going to give the analysis for it. So today's topic which I'm going to talk is about reincarnation. So everybody knows what is reincarnation. It is an ancient religious belief. It states that the soul transmigrates from one body to another. Necessarily doesn't mean body, so from one physical object to another physical object, which means that the soul, after leaving the dead body, enters the womb of another mother. So this is how the process of reincarnation works, and this document gives the main thing this document helps to give about reincarnation is intellectual completeness for reincarnation. That is, there are a lot of problems regarding reincarnation. So one of the main problems is why very few people only seem to remember the past lives. If you see the past life research done by Ian Stevenson and Jim B. Tucker, these two psychiatrists have done a lot of research about reincarnation children. What's the conclusion that it comes from the research is that very, very few percent of the human population only seem to have access to their past lives, and the rest of them don't even have a clue that there are past lives or not. So this Ian Stevenson research clearly says that only few people remember their past lives. And another problem with reincarnation is population explosion. So if there are 8 million souls, say 8 million bodies, which is human beings, because the body is the only thing that is visible in your five sense perception, so where are the souls coming from for all those 8 billion bodies? So this is another problem. Another problem is a close connection between mind and the brain, which leads many people to say that the brain is enough to explain about our consciousness, and another entity called soul is not needed. So that is one of those people are called as materialists. So those people reject the idea of a soul. So these are the problems of reincarnation, and this document clearly answers them. So one of the main things which comes as a revelation from this document is that the phenomenon of past life forgetfulness. That is the reason why many people do not have access to their immediate past lives. Immediate past lives are past lives which are further than the immediate past lives also. So no past life access is allowed. in this the phenomenon established by these people who are referred to as old empire prison operators. That is Roswell terminology. Only if you see the document and the PDF version, you will understand these terminologies. So I would first ask to check the document when you have time, and then come back to this video. So that's the main problem. This past life forgetfulness, not accessing past life is very key for people in remaining in ignorance. If only people have access to past lives, they will clearly know that they are not going to die with the death of the body. So that is a very key interpretation which people can make, but that has been completely extinguished by this past life forgetfulness phenomenon. So another thing is about regarding population explosion. So let us say, I'm just giving arbitrary numbers. Let us say 1 trillion souls have been dumped in this region of space about 50 to 70,000 years ago. Of those 1 trillion souls, according to population census, these are just not 100% exact numbers, but to an extent, these are accurate numbers. Population census says that there have been 120 billion human people on the human beings on this planet till date. Let us remove the exceptions of one human soul occupying more than one body. Those are extravagant exceptions. If you remove those exceptions, you can clearly see that for 120 billion people, you need 120 billion souls. The current population is 8 billion people. So 8 billion souls, distinct souls, is a must. Then the other 112 billion people who have been before the current population, for those 112 billion, it may be from the 8 billion souls itself. For example, one of the 8 billion souls may have incarnated 10 to 20 times in those 112 billion, or it could be a new soul from those 1 trillion souls which I said. So whichever way you look at it, the number of souls in the reincarnation cycle are more than enough to accommodate for the number of bodies in the bodies which are created in pregnancies. So population explosion problem is solved. So these are the defeated arguments for reincarnation, and all of these defeated arguments have been solved. So for now, we'll talk about the mechanism behind how this reincarnation works, how the soul and the body are tied together. So the soul and the body are tied together with the help of karma and prana. So first, when I say the word karma, many people think that it is about what the goods we do and what are the sins, but I'm not talking about that karma. That karma is obviously nonsense, because how the calculation takes place of good and bad, or how is the mechanism works, so that is not plausible. So the karma I'm talking about is responsible for our traits. It's like a subtler gene, if you may say. And this karma is the outer layer of the soul, and this karma and the soul soul generates prana too. So the way and the prana and the karma act as a glue between the soul and the body. So the way the prana behaves in each human being is different based on the karma. So the karma allotted for one life is called as prarabdha karma, and the whole bag of karma is referred to as sanchita karma. All of these things have been set up by these old prison operators for 50,000 to 70,000 years ago before itself. And this bag never ends, because in each lifetime, when you do actions which are not in full awareness, they accumulate karma. So the karma is always accumulated, the sanchita karma, and it never ends. So in such a way that the reincarnation cycle goes on. This karma is responsible for our, as I said, traits, our idiosyncratic traits, our compulsions, our aversions, all of our behavioral characteristics. This is responsible, along with the physical gene which the parents provide us. So these two factors are responsible for our behaviors, our conditioning and everything. So this is how the karma works, and as I said, it is never ending. So this is the now we will ask, for human souls it is fine, but what about animal souls? Because if you say that immortal spiritual beings are sentient beings, then if you cut the words beings, we will come to the fact that for anything to be sentient, it has to be an immortal spirit. So animals are also immortal spirits. How this matter? I will just see how this mechanism works for animals. If you see the biology chapter in this document, it clearly says that an ecologically interactive environment was set up in such a way that animals are compatible with each other. It necessarily doesn't mention about the souls, but we can infer from that. For example, for human soul, the human soul, after it leaves the body, has to enter another human mother's womb. In the in-between time, if the prarabdha does not end, that means if the allotted karma for the particular life, it's like a sand clock. So if the prarabdha does not end, that means that it has to end before the new set of prarabdha is generated. So for it to end, it may take on animal forms too. If you see the Roswell document, it is clearly given that some of the members of the Lost Battalion took on the forms of dolphins and whales. So that necessarily does not mean one has to take the form of dolphin or a whale, but it is one of the examples they saw. So like dolphins and whales, you can occupy any other body too, but ultimately you have to enter a mother's womb because the human soul is special. But it is necessarily not the case for animal souls. These animal souls should have been created by the Isbis itself long time back. If you check the life forms chapter, you can clearly see that long time back these souls must have been created, and they have been put in a cycle that they are interactive. For example, a dog soul after his death may enter a cat's body, a zebra soul may enter an elephant's body. It may mix and mingle. I am just giving random examples. So this is how the mechanism works for animal souls. Now we will also address one of the misconceptions in this video. In this video, it is given one example of Archduke Ferdinand that after the death, the soul goes to Mars. It is not like for everybody the soul goes to Mars. If something like that happens, means unnecessarily for each soul, every soul going to Mars and again coming back, it does not work. If that is true, then the souls occupying dolphins and whales cannot be true if you go to Mars. So that thing is just an exception which was done by the old number operators to the domain officer. So nobody is going to, no soul is going to Mars or some other base each life, and from there again coming back here. So it is just here only it is going on. So that clarification also has to be made. And another thing to address is at the end of the document, this is given that Gautam Buddha played an important role in getting the human beings out of the reincarnation cycle, but he is not the originator of the methods to get out of the cycle. The domains say that they don't have any method, and they don't know anybody in the universe having any method. So, but that is what they said throughout the document. But at the end of the document, they say that one of the beings of the old empire contacted with the domain, and that being gave them the methods. So only Matilda now has access to the past, to her past lives. That's what she claims. So for all of these things to be possible, the great being who is responsible for that is Indian god Shiva and his wife Parvati. So those two beings are only referred to at the end of the document, and whole humanity has to be thankful for them for giving us the methods to get out of the reincarnation cycle, and hope and we hope that one day they are introduced to us openly, because it looks like they have come as kings and queens. They have also come as another few characters in the last 500 years. But hopefully they come openly and introduce to us. And hopefully that day happens in the near future. So I want to acknowledge them for their help in getting the providing methods to get out of the human reincarnation cycle. So this is a gist about reincarnation, and we will discuss about another topic in the next video. So before ending the video, I want to say that the Buddhist monasteries which are currently existing today contain all these methods to get out of the reincarnation cycle. A lot of other ancient tribes also know these methods, which essentially come from the tradition of Shiva. And a very popular guru named as Sadguru Jaggi Vasudev, he claims that he also has escaped the reincarnation cycle, and he also has methods to get out of this reincarnation cycle. So there are lots of beings who have claimed to have methods to get out of the reincarnation cycle and whether take birth again or like a bodhisattva who wants to help humanity or just roam freely, whatever, that's completely the choice of these be. So these things can be possible, and essentially we have to credit Shiva for giving us the methods. So this is what I want to make as a final take. And if you like this video, please like the video, share the video, and subscribe to the channel for more content. I am going to release more videos, as I said, regarding this Roswell document, especially key topics which require clarification. So, and thank you for watching. Thank you.